on the stage at the Wolf Den is the catcher of the New York Yankees, Gary Sanchez. Hey, Gary. How are you?
Good.
How excited, Francis Marquez is along with him, yes, and will help interpret. How excited are you for the upcoming season? The team gets Garrett Cole. Everything seems to be going their way. How excited is he to start the 2020 year?
¿Cómo emocionado está con la temporada después que adquirieron a Garrett Cole?
Bueno, estamos muy emocionados que tenemos un pitcher. Ya que teníamos tremendo pitcher en la alineación, ahora tenemos a Garrett Cole. Que no va a ayudar bastante en este año.
Super excited. I mean, I thought we already had a pretty good pitching rotation, and Garrett just makes it that much better.
And how does he feel personally going into the season? Can he be even better than he's been?
¿Tú personalmente crees que puede ser aún mejor de lo que ha sido?
¿Quién, yo?
Mm-hmm.
Claro, estamos trabajando para eso. Me he fajado ahora en el off-season para venir ready para el spring trainer y poder estar saludable este año y poder ayudar más al equipo.
Of course, I always feel like I can get better, and I worked hard this offseason first and foremost to be healthy, and if I'm healthy, I think I can really help the team.
¿Qué tú tienes hacer para preparar para Garrett Cole? What do you have to do to prepare? Sorry, guys.
Oh, stop.
Spanish.
Brutal. Mal.
Nada, tratar de ver muchos videos. Trata de hablar con él cuando tenga el chance ahora en el pitch trainer. Para eso que venimos para el pitch trainer, para conocer los pitches nuevos que vienen. Y yo creo que vamos a hacer tremendo trabajo juntos.
Before spring training, I see a lot of video. And then once we get to camp, I'm going to sit down and talk to him a lot throughout camp in order for him and I to have a good rapport.
Okay, Francis, I'm going to need you on this one.
Sure.
Okay? You're behind the plate. Jose Altuve hits a home run to send them to the World Series. Did he know what pitch was coming?
I don't think I even have to translate that.
No sé, Altuve es un tremendo bateador también. La verdad no sé si él sabía. Yo vi la entrevista que él dijo que él estaba buscando el slider. Ya sería preguntarle a él.
Listen, Jose Altuve is a great hitter. I don't know if he did or if he didn't. I heard the interview that he gave that he said that he was sitting slider. So I guess we'll never know.
But with the scandal and the allegations, does he believe they were robbed of at least an opportunity to win a championship?
¿Y con las alegaciones, tú sientes que se les robó la oportunidad de ganar un campeonato?
¿Con cuál?
Con las alegaciones de que robaron señas.
Bueno, puede ser. Uno nunca sabe. Nosotros teníamos tremendo equipo para competir con cualquiera. Y no es lo mismo cuando tú sabes, cuando viene un picheo y cuando tú sabes que no, cuando no viene. El chance de poder batir más alto cuando tú sabes cuando viene un picheo.
It could be. I mean, we had a really good team. I thought we had a great team, a championship caliber team, and it's definitely not the same thing knowing what's coming versus not knowing what's coming.
2017, it's been proven that the Astros cheated. They've been punished for it. The manager was fired. The GM was fired. CC Sabathia has come out and said, we got robbed. We should have won the World Series. We would have beaten the Dodgers. Do most of the guys on that team feel that way?
O sea, se demostró que en el 2017 sí se están robando señas. Ya sí salió y dijo, mira, ellos nos robaron un campeonato y nosotros lo hubiésemos ganado porque lo hubiésemos ganado a los Dodgers. El equipo en general, ¿tu sentir es que se siente así?
Bueno, puede ser. Yo no me siento muy bien con eso también. Yo creo que cualquier otro equipo que le han hecho lo mismo también se puede sentir igual. Nosotros estábamos haciendo la cosa bien, legal. Si ellos estaban haciendo trampa, yo creo que ellos tenían más ventaja que nosotros porque ellos sabían ya lo que venía. Si es verdad que estaban haciendo trampa.
Yeah, we do feel that way. I mean, we were doing things right. We were doing things by the book. And to know that that a team had an unfair advantage over us is disappointing.
Did he ever hear the banging of the trash cans that we've heard about in 2017?
Yo no he escuchado, nunca no lo escuché, ¿no? Los videos que vi, que salieron muchos videos en internet y eso, ahí yo dije, wow, pero es verdad que yo estaba usando eso. Entonces, cuando yo estaba quechando, nunca me enfocaba siempre en el pitcher, no me enfocaba en lo que pasaba por fuera.
I never heard it, I was really too focused on the pitcher, but afterwards I saw videos, and in the videos you could hear it, and there I realized that, wow, they were banging on a trash can.
You know, so much goes through with Major League Baseball with multiple signs that people don't steal signs. Does Gary think it would be a good idea to be able to have the catcher talk to the pitcher with an earpiece in?
Hay tanto revuelo con esto del robar señas. ¿Tú crees que sería buena idea que haya como una manera de comunicarse el pitcher y el catcher directamente?
La verdad no sé, porque si yo le hablo al pitcher, el bateador está ahí mismo, cuando el bateador le escucha. Hay que buscar una manera, no sé, de poder dar más señas cuando yo esté echando. Busco una forma.
I don't know, because I guess potentially the hitter's right there next to me. Potentially he could hear what I'd be saying to him. So for us, it's just a matter of switching up signs as much as we can to make sure we address it.
That was going to be my question, is how much is it incumbent on not allowing yourself to be the victim, to make sure that you change things so that even if they do steal signs, you can be one step ahead.
O sea, que cuán importante es que tú sí cambies señal y que tú te mantengas un paso hacia adelante yo para que no te roben la señal.
Bueno, importante para nosotros es para que no vayan a pasar lo que pasó, que nos roben la seña y eso. Siempre tenemos que estar alerta con todas las cosas que vaya a pasar en el terreno. Yo como catcher tengo que estar pendiente a que si me están cogiendo la seña o no, tratar de cambiarla siempre. Yes.
It's super important. It's part of the adjustments that we make throughout the game. And for me as a catcher, that's something important that I have to do, that I have to notice if, in fact, my pitchers and my signs are being stolen and be able to adjust to that.
I've heard from so many people, and I've even read it as well, that on the last pitch of last season, that Chapman is the only Yankee pitcher that does not use multiple signs. Why is that? Does he just feel uncomfortable with it?
Puede ser que él no sé, de nada no se lo explicaron, pero el único sí que no la está usando era él.
That is true. He is the only one that doesn't use multiple signs. It may be just that he doesn't feel comfortable with it, or that no one really sat down to explain to him the situation.
I know that Gary wants to win so much. So many people want to win so much. And I wonder that after Altuve ends the season with that one swing, does he sit at home going over that pitch selection? Maybe we should have gone with a fastball. Why did we go with that? Is that something that stays all winter with him?
Considerando cómo se acabó la temporada de ustedes con ese picheo del tuve, después que se acabó ese juego, ¿tú te quedas en tu casa pensando en ese picheo, en que hubiese tirado otro, hubiese hecho algo distinto?
Bueno, siempre eso le pasa a uno por la cabeza, nada más no en ese juego. Siempre cuando le dan un jonrón a un pitcher, uno siempre se pone a pensar, wow, si hubiera tirado este otro picheo, quizás hubiera sido diferente. Y eso siempre nos pasa a nosotros, a mí como catcher me pasa.
Yeah, for me as a catcher, that happens, and not just on that pitch, it always happens. Every time you give up a home run, you always kind of think of what you could have, should have done differently in that particular pitch.
Yeah, it's so weird. I think about, Gary's such a great offensive player, but when he's on defense, he can't be, like Paul O'Neill used to practice a swing in right field. He's got to be locked in. I mean, how do you do both? I mean, does it take away from his hitting that he has to think about all this stuff when he's catching?
Es tan difícil, considerando que tú eres tan bueno ofensivo, que tú a la misma tienes que estar tan enfocado en tu defensa. Es difícil poder hacer algo. Te quita de la ofensiva tener que pensar tanto en la defensiva.
Bueno, es algo que yo he estado siempre trabajando. No es fácil. Para mí se me hace muy, muy difícil. A veces estoy bateando bien, no estoy echando bien. A veces estoy echando bien, no estoy bateando bien. Es algo que siempre trato de mantenerme igual, como hacer lo mismo siempre, tratar de cuando vaya a defender, enfocado en defensa, cuando vaya a batear, enfocado en el bateo. Pero es algo difícil, no fácil.
You're right. It's not easy. I mean, I have to be able to separate both. So sometimes I'm not hitting, and I have to make sure that I'm able to play defense well. Sometimes I'm playing defense well, and I'm not hitting. So I have to make sure that one doesn't affect the other. But it definitely is very tough.
Get a first baseman's mitt. Don't have to think.
A lot of fans felt like the LeMahieu home run made it worse. Like, if they had just not come back, it might have been easier to lose than the home run. How does Gary as a player feel about losing in the fashion they did?
Algunos fanáticos piensan que el home run de LeMahieu lo hace peor porque vinieron para atrás el home run y de momento perder de esa manera. ¿Qué tú crees? ¿Fue peor así?
No. Las cosas pasaron como tenían que pasar, tú me entiendes. Ese home run nos levantó el ánimo, nos dio un chance para poder ganar. Ya que no lo pudimos hacer porque vinieron y nos dejan en el terreno, pero yo creo que no fue malo, no tan mal.
No, it just shows that we were fighting up until the end, and I mean, we lost. I mean, and there's nothing we can say about that, but it shows that we were fighting.
There have been times on this show when we've defended you quite a bit at moments. Yankees fans are very passionate, and there have been times when people have questioned your hustle and your motor, as they say. Does that bother you? Does it get to you when people question your effort level?
Nosotros en este programa muchas veces te hemos defendido porque los fanáticos de Yankees son bien apasionados y a veces cuestionan tu esfuerzo y el esfuerzo que tú haces en el terreno. ¿Eso te molesta a ti?
Tú sabes que yo me enfoco siempre en tratar de salir al terreno y ayudar a mi equipo de atrás. Ese es mi enfoque. Bloqueo los comentarios de afuera, me enfoco en mi equipo, a tratar de ayudar al pitcher lo más que yo pueda, de ayudar al equipo bateando lo más que yo pueda y de jugar la pelota bien.
I focus on doing my job on the field. You can't play in this city if you listen to those critics. So I'm focused on helping the pitcher, helping the team win, and not on what people say outside.
All right, before we let Gary go, how many wins this year? How many games can this team win?
¿Cuántos juegos tú quieres ganar?
No sé, pero puede ser que lleguemos a 100. Tenemos tremendo equipo. El año teníamos buen equipo, muchas lesiones y eso. Si el equipo se mantiene saludable, yo creo que podemos ganar lo mismo que ganamos el año pasado y quizás más.
Not sure, but I think we have the chance to win the same or more games than last year.
You know what's sad? I took 8 years of Spanish, and I can pick out maybe 6 or 7 words, like... Pregunta, I know, it's sad. 8 years I couldn't do it.
Replace took with wasted.
I guess it was wasted. I feel embarrassed. I should be able to. I mean, we expect players to speak English. I should be able to speak to Gary, and I took 8 years, and it was wasted. I just couldn't do it.
What do you think of that? 8 años.
Que siga aprendiendo.
No, Gary says you got to keep on trying.
Okay, I'll try. Gary Sanchez, everybody, we thank you for coming by. We really appreciate it. I'll see you tonight, then I'll see you in Tampa.
Thank you.
So that's Gary Sanchez, and we thank Francis Marquez as well for translating. When we come back, Gary's team.